I'll start this video out by assuming that you've already taken your strut assembly out and disassembled it. If you haven't, check out the video on how to disassemble a strut assembly. I've got the new parts on the bottom of the screen and the old parts up top. We're comparing the old to new and seeing what parts we have to swap out. This is supposed to come out. It is definitely bad. We're replacing that for sure. Here's the replacement. The spring. This spring might be good, might be bad, but we're upgrading the performance of this car, so we're getting the performance spring to match this performance strut. This is part of the strut tower mount. The bushing goes in here, also the bump stop. So I clean this up, we're gonna reuse this, it's in decent enough shape. This is the bump stop, or what's left of the bump stop. It was really mangled up before I had to go at it, and after I did, it's got even worse. There's no way you're gonna reuse that, so got a new one. This is a little stiffer than the old one. It's a different material. It should last longer. This is the strut tower bushing. This being as bad as it was actually inspired this whole suspension rebuild project. I'm gonna upgrade to this polyurethane bushing. It's a lot stiffer. It should last longer. It may provide a slightly bumpier ride because it doesn't have as much give to it. But the thing that should be providing all the give is the spring and the strut. So we'll let that do the job, and this will hold it in place. It'll do its job. This is a component that wasn't actually on the original strut. This holds the brake hose and the speed sensor wire in place. Should they loosen themselves up, they won't be able to go very far. We'll add this on later. Start by making sure you have the correct side. Sometimes the part number itself will have an L or an R signifying left or right, and that's based on you in the driver's seat, your left and your right. We're working on the left side today. There's the L. Some springs will actually have a top and a bottom to them. This one does not. Sometimes it'll be as easy as just looking at the spring and you'll see one side's thinner than the other. So if this was small at the top and you see that this fits perfectly into the base here, you know the top end is going to be the small end. So now that we know that this spring goes in either way, we can just slide this on top. You want to make sure that the end of your spring lines up with the end stop on your strut. If you're using a clamp rather than a zip tie, make sure you put that on first before you slide it onto the shaft here. Sometimes it's easier to put the bump stop in first without the shaft getting in your way. There we go. This bearing is what everything rides on whenever you're turning the steering wheel. The bushing stays put in ideal situations, and this rotates, letting the whole spring assembly and strut assembly rotate with the wheel. All right, that looks good. On original springs in particular, these things come way out and you have to use the spring compressor to bring them back down. On this, since these springs are actually shorter than the original springs, you can press this down just enough sometimes to get the threads to show. On some strut assemblies, you won't have to deal with this kind of bearing, and this will come together really easily. But because this isn't seating properly, I'm gonna break out the spring compressor and compress this, line it up properly. The end result you wanna have is that this bearing is flush with the spring seat, so that in 500 miles, you don't end up having binding and having to replace this whole thing again. Figured out what the issue was. I initially installed this bump stop up top, which made it way too high, and the bearing would not ever seat until this thing is completely compressed, and you don't want that. I'm gonna put a little bit of silicone lube on the inside of this, just so it slides a little easier for installation. Even though I got that bump stop straightened out, this still doesn't wanna quite line up properly, but it does a lot better job than it used to, so. Now I'm gonna make sure the bearing is seated properly. It currently is. I'm gonna hold it down in place while I loosen these clamps. Much better. Nut isn't on all the way, so I can rotate this, and the bearing isn't making any weird noises. The bottom of this bushing has the same gap all the way around. Looks like we can tighten this nut up. This bellows is gonna be tricky to put into place because the spring is gonna be in the way of your hands, and you're gonna have to expand it quite a bit because the spring is currently at its maximum expansion. So you're gonna have to expand that bellows as long as it's probably ever going to be. Once you get this clampable end where you want it, in this case, it's past the plastic portion down to the metal, Then you can slide your clamp over it and tighten just enough to keep it in place. It doesn't need to be tightened super tight, it just needs to stay put. This is the side that attaches the steering knuckle, so this is going to be facing outwards. So I'm going to rotate this clamp in such a way that if I ever need to take it off for some reason, it's going to be easy to access. And that is one assembled strut. All that's left to do now is bolt it to the steering knuckle down here. And after it goes up through the top of the strut tower on the car, there's a giant metal rubber washer that goes on top of here, and then a second nut that spins on the top, and it's held in place. If you don't have a quirky car like mine, odds are you won't deal with a whole lot of stuff up top here. It'll just be a pre-assembled bracket that you can replace the whole thing, be done with it. Usually those have two or three either studs or holes for bolts to hold it in place. They're a lot easier to work with, but if you're not that lucky, now you know how to deal with it. If you're curious about how to take one of these apart or how to use a spring compressor, I've got a video on how to disassemble this that goes into more detail on both of those things, so check that video out. Hopefully this made working on your car just a little bit easier, and always wear your safety equipment.